Hello crafty friends, it's Suzy Chocolate here from Suzy Chocolate Crafts. Now it has been such a long time since I've made a video so here we are today, and I thought I would drop in and show you how I'm making this card. It's nothing has stuck together there apart other than the flower that I've made. This is going to be a birthday card for my sister-in-law, and it's inspired by Marta De Becker from Drop of Sunshine. I am on Marta's friend design team, and so I have been watching lots of her lives and following her for now for quite a while, and really do love the way that she layers up so many things and makes her cards look really, really very, very special. And so this is going to be a card very similar to that. And so what I have done is I've got an 8-inch card base, so there's my 8-inch ready-made card base, which isn't actually 8 inches, but it's just under. And then I've got a piece of gold glitter card, and then let's just unlayer it. So let's just move that aside, and so I've used a sheet of paper out of Marta's Drop of Sunshine Goodbye Summer Digital Bundle, which is $3.99 from Craftstash. And this is just showing you, I've used quite a few bits out of it, but I've printed it off, and these are the papers that are in the bundle. And there's lots of sentiments. You can print them at whatever size you like. There's butterflies, bigger sentiments, circles, and ephemera without sentiments. And this sheet of paper, which I've obviously used, I've given it a bit more colour to match the flower that I've made. And so you can probably see it there. It's got musical notes, it's got shadowed butterflies in the back. It did have a little bit of peachy colour along with some grey and sort of buffy colour, which is a really pretty pastel shades. But I've tore it up. I've learned that off Marta. When she first said, tear your paper up, it's like, oh my God, I can't do that. I'm getting to, like the effect that it actually gives. And so I've torn it up, I've been and coloured the edges with a little bit of Versa Magic Red Magic multi-surface chalk ink, and I did that with a dry wipe. And so I just put a little bit of ink and gone around the edges, and I've also used a little bit of brushed corduroy distress oxide as well, just to give that sort of faded older look. And so let's just shift them off of there. I'm going to try and keep them in some sort of order, because I've sort of got them in an order that I want them to be in. And so let's do that. And that's the sentiment. And then the next layer is made out of a stencil on just some white card. It's just a bundle of stencils that I bought from Amazon. I think there's about 10 or maybe more, 10 or 20 in there. And I chose one of them to try out some new Tonic Nouveau Mica Mists. Yeah, and so I saw these in the sale. They were $4.99 for the three, and they're really a huge, lot bigger than I thought they were going to be. If you look at how that's laying in my hand, it's a good old size. But this green one is a lot different in colour than I expected it to be. In the picture it looked really bright green, like a pear green, So I was trying it out last night and I thought I'd spray it through one of these stencils, and so that's what I did. And so this is the positive. So I just laid that on a piece of white card, give it a good old spray. Actually, I put it in a cardboard box that I use for using all my sprays and paints and things. And then carefully whipped it off, let it dry. I've trimmed it down to, I don't know what the even size that is. What size is that? 5.5, just over 5.5 by 5.5. And I have ruffled the edges with this scuffy thing. And then I've put a little bit of brushed corduroy on the edge of that. I'm now going to put some embossing ink, clear embossing ink, and then some gold embossing powder on top of that. And so then that will sit on the top of that. And then I have just a plain circle that I found in my Oddsy Bits. So that's a like a satin mirror card. And then I've got this die cut, which, yeah, it's cut on the back of, I don't know what I printed on there. Yeah, this was going to be the lid for a box that I've been fiddling about with. Where is it? Oh, here it is. It's just, it's a box that a cake came in, actually. It's about 4 or 5 inches. And I've given it a wipe over, and I thought that I would decorate it. And I cut this because I thought it fitted really nicely on the top in the plain white. But then when I was looking at this this card that I'm now making today, when I was looking at that last night, I thought, oh, that would fit nicely on the top there. So I'm going to stand that up on some foam, I think. And then we'll put the flowers and things on. So should we get started? And I think I'll do a little bit of... yeah, I've got this nice word stencil that I'm going to put on top of this once I've got it stuck down. So I'm going to sit down now and get some glue and start sticking this on. Just get me glue off. I had my nails painted for the first time, gelled in colour. For the first time, and I feel a bit conscious about them. I hope they look all right. I've been growing my nails for about 5 years now, and they have eventually got some substance and thickness to them. And so I have had them done with a French manicure with the white ends. I'm not technical on nails. I have no idea about nails, really. But is that the right way up? Yeah. So I'm going to try and leave like a edged border. I have sort of cut and ruffled the edges some. So, yeah, I have had my nails done with this, with the French polish before, but I've never, ever had a colour on them. So I feel a bit self-conscious. So what do you think? Do you think they look all right? They are getting to be quite a nice length, so... right, should we put that one there? I might just tear that off, and just give me a little dry cloth and give that a little bit of pink down there. And that doesn't look such a harsh. Actually, I might tear that whole thing off. Make it a bit of a softer edge. Like that. And then we can stick that on. I should have filled my glue up before I started. I've got everything else prepared. I haven't done a recording for such a... Well, probably since... don't know... March, when because I had my shoulder replaced in March, and at the end of March, and so it would have been just before that. So I haven't done any recording since then. I feel so rusty. I'm gonna leave a little border down there and sort of one there. So I've got a new tripod that I've been setting up one for today, rather than I had a gooseneck thing that was a bit wobbly, and whenever I cut anything on the table or pressed on, it wobbled, and so it wasn't very good. And so I bought this little tripod, but I've really struggled in getting it set up today, so the legs don't show. I'm sure that I'm missing a trick. Hopefully this little video will turn out well, and I will be able to get back to doing some more tutorials and things, because I love crafting, and I've quite missed it actually. The summer has been really quite busy with the garden, and we've got into watching the birds, and my other half has got into camera photography, and so we've sort of, our interests have gone elsewhere at the moment, and so I really haven't even done any crafting or made much at all. But it's coming up for that time of year when I've got to start making some cards for Christmas. What do we think here? It's not looking too bad, is it? As usual, the glue runs out. Sorry about that. I looked out the window and it's absolutely heaving down my rain, so I just had to go and get the washing in. Oh, I got soaked. And I put a jacket on. I put it on my head. And so let's just carry on. I've just made a little bit just to fit in there, and I think we're almost done. And so I just need to put a little bit of this red magic around the edges, give it a little bit of extra colour. Like that. And just slice that bottom bit off a bit. Give it a bit of a straighter edge, give that a rough up. I don't know what that little tool is called. My memory and names are not good. So, is that up the right way? Yes, the butterflies are up the right way. Then we can have that one there, like that. And I filled my glue up, so we're now back on the little container. I might stick that one underneath, actually. So let's just have a little look and see what's going to be showing. Oh, that's not so bad, is it? Not so bad at all. Right, so let's get a little bit of texture paste. This is embossing paste, a little bit of white embossing paste, and pop. I think I'm gonna, so that's gonna be sitting like that. So I'm gonna do some down the side, I think. Yeah, like that. I always say I'm going to have a bowl of water to drop these sorts of things into, and then I never do bring it in. Not just when I'm recording, but just when I'm crafting, so that they don't get gummed up. But actually that looks like it's come up quite clean. So I'm just going to quickly heat dry that. Helps if I turn the electricity on, I think. I'm so disorganized today. I can't believe it. I hate being disorganized. Right, so we've got some, yes, we've got some power now. I'm just going to let that heat up a little bit. It's dried nicely. So I've got that on there now. I've purposefully left the like a squarish board around the edge. Yeah, I don't think that looks so bad. Right, so the next thing is to get on with this. And so, as I said, this is a spray, a shimmer spray on some white card. I'll cut down, I've ruffled the edges. You can do that with your scissors if you haven't got one of these little bladey tool things. You can just do that with scissors. I've coloured a little bit with some brushed corduroy, and I'm now going to get an embossing clear embossing ink, and I'm just going to go around the edges and then put on a bit of gold embossing powder. I think that's all four sides done, and now on a piece of paper, and I've got some bright gold here. Let's have a look and see. If you try this and if it goes up, if you've put a little bit too much embossing ink and you've got a bit too high, then just brush it roughly off with your fingers. Oh. See that extra sparkle? Oh, that looks nice, doesn't it? Okay, so I'm going to, should I stick that up on some foam? Yeah, I think I will. Just get the foam tape. Right, here's some foam. This is quite thick foam tape. I think this is probably 3 mil, I should think this is. So, just pop some glue down. So that's that layer on. And then this one, yeah, I think that on its own doesn't really show up. That's why I'm going to put that one under there. So, and then this, I have put a little bit of, I did rub a little bit of this red on, tiny little bit underneath, and then I've put some Inca Gold, what is that, fast dry metal gloss paint. It's solid, so I don't know what it's called, a paint, but it's solid, and I've just rubbed my finger on it and gone around it with this little dry wipe and just polished it. And so that it's, hopefully you can see the extra shine that we're getting there on that. So that gives another layer of depth and a little bit of the pink in the middle. Oh, let's have that over there so we can cover that up with a flower. That little bit of, I've gone over the edge there. Right, so I think I'm going to put that up on tape. can hear a funny little squeaking noise. That's my dog who's dreaming. I can hear him, bless him. He's 14 and a half years old, and he does sleep rather heavy nowadays. His legs will be kicking. He can run faster in his dreams than he can in real life now, bless his little heart. He was a championship agility dog. That's what I used to do before I was crafting. He had two speeds, flat out or flat asleep. Nothing in between. Those were the days. Lots of happy memories. Right. So where's the bit? So this is the bit I messed up, I think, isn't it? So if we have that like that, it's actually quite good because the circle underneath comes into the shape of these little scallops that come out the edge. So I'm quite pleased with that. Tiny little bit of glue that has just popped out there, and that's the sort of thing that will annoy me. I know it dries clear, but let's just get a bit of it out if I can. Yeah, then there won't be such a lump. That's good. Oh, nice. So building up some nice layers here. So I think it's time to pop it onto this card. I'm going to have a side opening card. So let's just cover this in glue. Collar on the back of this, I think. That'll give it some nice stiffness when it dries. That's the one thing I like about collar. It does really strengthen up your projects. So I think I'm going to have that. I love these little whorls. I can't remember what dye that was now, but I'll pop it in the description below. But I use it a lot in my projects because it's just, you can pull these little things up and get some lift as well. Give it a bit of dimension so it's not flat. So you can pop them up and then they spring almost. So I think I'm going to have that like that. Oops, leave up there. And then these leaves are, these are Heartfelt Creation leaves, I think. And I've coloured them, and I've also painted them in a little bit of the two-tone coloured in ink, and then I've painted them in a little bit of glossy accents to give them a nice little shine, and it also sets them so they're really quite stiff as well. And I think I'm going to have that. This is a Heartfelt Creations die as well. I think that's the Dahlia? Yeah. And that's stamped in this red ink. I've stamped it in the red ink, then I've gone round the edges a little bit with the dry wipe on there, and then I've also wiped on it some of the ink, some of this Inca gold. I don't know if you can, yeah, you can just see some of the gold sparkles up the middle. So I've just put a little, few little highlights on it, and then these were gold stamens with white. They had white bases, but I've coloured them with the ink as well so that they're matching. And so then they've just got a lot of wily stamens coming out of the top of it, of that little flower. Just giving a little shape with a shaping tool. And so I think I'm going to do something like this. And that's a slightly different colour. But I think it looks all right like that. And then this, I think I might put some gold embossing on that, and then we can have that. That can sit there, I think. And so let's get that finished off. A bit of hot glue gun. And oops. Let's see if we can get this stuck down. Pop that aside, and I'm going to just go around this with a little bit of this brushed corduroy, give it a little bit of aging. I think I'm going to change the colour of that butterfly too, the orange butterfly. The blue one I have painted with some of the green spray. I don't know if, yeah, you can see there, that's made that all shimmery and more green. I think I need to paint that red rather than being the orangey colour that it is. And I do that colour, that corduroy colour, if you wonder why I've done that, it's just in case any bits of gold are missed, and then the it doesn't show, that you've missed up some gold. So that's just got a little gold rim all the way around the edge. Just a nice fine one, but it just lifts up the colour. Okay, and it matches the rest of somebody's at the door. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to do, I'm going to just curve this with my bone folder. Just give it a shape. And then I'm going to pop that on there. So I will pop it on there and then I will be back. So I'm back. I'm sorry about that disturbance there. That was a nice friend pop round to see me. And so I have stuck this end here, this is the right end, down with some hot glue. And at this end, I've put a little bit of the same foam tape as I've put this centre panel on, because I didn't want it to be lopsided. And so I'm just going to pop a little bit of hot glue onto here, and then I'll be able to make the curve in the here, and just rise that up a little bit. And is that level? Hopefully that's level. Stand up. Yeah, I think that's level. So that's the happy birthday on. You might notice that I've started to paint. I said I was going to change the colour of this orange butterfly there. I've just put a little bit of red. So I've put some of the Versamagic that I've used everywhere else. I've put on my glass mat and add a little bit of water. I'm just going to tap with this tiny little paintbrush. I'm just going to pop a little bit of this colour into here so that the orange isn't quite so orange and it matches up more with the rest of the card. I think that as that dries, that will go the same colour as that. And so it's a much deeper orange that matches up with the flower. And so that was a tiny little bit of that. So I'll just mop that up so I don't get that everywhere over the back of the card. I've had to clean my glass mat, because that was a bit mucky with some glue. And had a nice tidy up. So hot glue, I think we're finished with the hot glue because everything is now off. Everything is now on, sorry. And so the last thing I'm going to do is just add a few of these Nuva drops. Now I've got a lot of Nuva drops, but I didn't realise that that Nuva makes something called Aroma Drops. There's only a few in the range. This is called Damask Rose, and I've just popped a little bit onto that piece of paper there so you can see it. It's a sort of a dusky pink, but once it dries, when it dried, it did have a little sort of orangey background note in it. And so I thought that it looked really, really nice and matched in with the colour. This is just a fresh, I've just done this. But the thing is, they smell, their aroma is rose, and I wish this was smelly video so you could, because the smell is just divine. I think there's a magnolia and two or three others. I can't remember what they all are now, but it's the first time that I've seen them. So I'm just going to put a few little drops here and there to give some highlights and a little bit of texture. So I think I'm going to put a few coming off of the end of this leaf here. Just like that. And should I do the same down here? Might just do the same down here, I think. Up. So how many do I do? 5. So let's just bring it down. Don't want it in a straight line. Just want to. There we are. Oh, and the smell. It's beautiful. Really is beautiful. And then I'll just do a few on this centre here. I just want to rest my hand somehow. Like that. When the Nuva drops are dry, I will put I'm going to put a sentiment inside. This is the sentiment that I'm going to put inside. It says, "May your birthday be filled with the warm sunshine of love and the bright rainbow colours of laughter." That's out of a card making magic set. And I'm going to stamp that in the centre in black, some VersaFine black in the inside of the card. And I've just got to put my stamp on the back of the card. So here is the completed card. I've made the box and I've used the corresponding colours. So I've made a two-tone box in a lovely orangey colour, top and dusky pinky bottom, and I have used another sheet of martyr's paper on the top. I've done a happy birthday across there, which is from Bright Rosa. I've cut out one of the butterflies and popped on the top there for a little bit of dimension, just ruffled around the edges and coloured again with that little bit of pink. And then let me just pop that aside. And then inside the box, I've covered it with a piece of gold tissue, and then there is the card inside. I've added a little butterfly just to bring the butterflies from here, from the sentiment to there, to match the top of the box as well. And so the completed card just lifts out on the tissue. And there's the sentiment. May your birthday be filled with the warm sunshine of love and the bright rainbow colours of laughter. And I've just popped a little bit of glue under there to hold the tissue in place. But that's another two-tone coloured paper there. So that was a 12 by 12 piece of paper, that card that I've used to make the box. It's reinforced sides, and also the top has reinforced sides as well. And so that's nice and sturdy. So that was an 8¼-inch box that I've made there out of some 12 by 12 papers. And I'll get in my next video, I think I will make a box out, an 8-inch box out of A4 papers, and just show you how you can do that in case you haven't got any 12-inch square paper. And so that's my card for today. So I hope you've enjoyed it, and let me know what you think about the style of this card. Do you like the one flower? I think because it is so big on its own, I do think it looks okay. Should I put two little ones beside it? I'm not sure. You let me know. What do you think? That's it from me today. Until next time, and there will be a next time quite soon. Take care, my friends, and much love to you all. Bye bye.